And for those of y'all who don't know what the greatest it means, the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those, so thank you very much. Here it goes. This is the part I was worried about. Everyone thinks that my career is down the tubes, and I'm in some dusty garage inhaling them carbon monoxide fumes, and everyone's telling me what I should do and how I should come out of what to rap about. And I know that I got a lot up in my Abdullah Abdangada that I gotta get out, and I'm not sure how this is gonna come off. They're probably gonna think that I'm coming off as cocky. Like I just started giving a fuck what you really think about me. See, the thing about me is you don't really know a thing about me. Everyone's making a stink about me, like there's some kind of an aura of that of the king around me. Surround me with other big gangsters, killers and bangers, and the most dangerous criminals, and I feel like I'm more comfortable around them than I do my own motherfucking neighbors. But see, my dream is to be remembered as one of the best when I leave. But why does it seem like I'm not even put up in the same category as other MCs? So when Weezy says that he's better than Jay-Z, please be that just subliminally. Means he thinks Jigga's the best and that he's the only one up in that league, see? And it's easy just to consider me one of the greatest white rappers there is, knowing goddamn well that I'm one of the best motherfucking rappers who ever lived, period. I'm a GOAT, and I don't mean to glow, but I know what I know and I know what you think. And these magazines, I'll never put it in ink, because how would it look if they considered me as a GOAT? And for those of y'all who don't know what a GOAT is, it means the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those, so thank you very much. Here it goes. Maybe they figure that I'm on my way out the game, so they gotta go try to find my new women and more new shady. If they think it's gonna happen, man, I thought I was crazy. Or maybe I could be taking it wrong and they're trying to pay homage to me in a strange way. So let me pay homage to my fellow white competitors almost in the same way. See, you hardly ever do hear anyone even bringing up Paul Walls White, cause lyrically he doesn't pose a threat to anyone. See, he's just die. And Bubba Sparks, he just won't write, because he's so caught up in that Snow White. The Timberland can't even get him in the studio, he's still going off that coke, right? And it's so sad, cause he's dope, right? America's next great white hope, right? So now they feel like they gotta come up with some corny ass white rabbit show, right? And which I'm still having mixed feelings about. They said it'd be real, I'm just spilling it out. There's something about a white boy talking black and running around with a damn grill in his mouth. And I love when they say that's Tiger Woods shit. Isn't it ironic that the best rapper's white and the best golfer's black? And I'm the one who's gotta catch all the flack over that. But these are the people who never had heard of an Eminem until 8 Mile that came out. But I had already hit middle America. Parents just all got to liking me now. And suddenly I wasn't such a bad guy. All of the hatred for me must have died. Thought I committed career suicide, so I had to turn back into the bad guy. So faggoty, 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 Gay's Anatomy guy made Raggedy Ann and Andy. Not Raggedy Andy and Andy and Andy. And Angelina Jolie is just another hoe. And Brad is a sucker, because once I fuck her, she wants to go to Somalia to adopt another baby. You know what I say? No. You better say some of them kiss from Madonna. She needs all the publicity she can get. You want the shady? Well, you got it, man. I ain't apologizing for shit. I'm a GOAT, and I don't mean to glow, but I know what I know and I know what you think. And these magazines, I'll never put it in ink, because how would it look if they considered me as a GOAT? And for those of y'all who don't know what a GOAT is, it means the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those, so thank you very much. Here it goes. Man, I'm taking my ball and going home, man. This shit is too easy. Nobody wants to even pass me the ball, cause
I'm a GOAT.
So don't worry, I'm out the motherfucking game. And y'all can sit and argue about who's the motherfucking best, but y'all know
that I'm a GOAT.
And like I said, I'm one of the motherfucking best. Before you get your panties in a motherfucking bunch. Before I go, I'd like to say fuck you very much to everybody who wasn't there from the start. And thank you very much to everybody who was. And you only gotta say it, just think it. Cause I know that you know that I know that you know that I know that
I'm a GOAT.
I'm out, y'all. It's been real.
I'm a GOAT.